a young passer.
My number one attribute as an athlete probably is my ability to catch the football. I can't take credit for how I can catch the football, but I can take credit for once realizing that I had a special gift and all the different things from paraffin baths. I'm talking about early in the 90s starting to do that. I started getting manicures back in the 80s and started taking care of my hands and started doing a lot of flexibility exercises and strengthening my hands. I started doing fingertip push-ups to increase the overall elasticity. All those things lead to being able to catch it like that.
Okay.
I like that last one. He's got a nice little bump.
Oh, it's a nice little shape.
Yeah, yeah, that dude is ripped.
Great job by the folks of the Vikings, and I want to see much more of this. But what's up with the hair, bro?
It was a page out of the 80s.
I mean, but
yeah, they did. Yeah, they made me as if I had all the kid and play thick mustache.
Right.
They took my rookie mustache just to make sure they didn't let me know they didn't forget. But I've never had the kid in play. I've always had a fairly low haircut.
Right.
And when I was younger, I had braids and everything.
Oh, I'd like straight to see a back. Picture of one of those. Oh, I didn't know that.
Wait, how long? Or just all?
Just braided straight back, like 5 or 6 braids.
Your standard, fullback braids.
Yeah, my sisters used to braid it. I would say down to the bottom of my neck.
Oh, wow. Hold on real quick, though. They showed your cartoon guy doing fingertip push-ups. You still do those as recently as 12 hours ago.
Yeah, when I'm training kids and everything, I show them the drills and everything, get down on it and everything. Yeah, I still do it.
Awesome. Obviously, the way that you did it there, right? Your legs elevated. They were like handstand fingertip push-ups.
Yeah.
You showed the kids.
And the boom boom, not quite. A little more flat.
Stories to start your mornings. Last night, Gardner Minshew led the Jags to a win over the Tennessee Titans. Minshew, the main mustached man, went 20 of 30, 204 passing yards, 2 touchdowns. See, what do you think of Minshew's performance last night?
I thought it was awesome. I love to see young guys that can throw the football. You see that he's had good training. You don't have to be a 5-star recruit. You don't have to go to one of the big schools. I love the way they get coached up. They get in the game, and the game is not too big for them. Also, man, they say this guy squats 500 pounds. His dad, you see his dad oh, man, he was jacked.
He went to...
It's a great story.
He went to the University of Alabama to be the third quarterback because he thought he was going to go into coaching. Now he's starting in the NFL. And you, Chris Carter, you laughed at me and thought I was just being a Chiefs homer when after Gardner Minshew came in relief and played great. I said, we have to be open to the possibility. What if this kid's actually a star? What if this kid's good? And through 2 weeks, man, they were a 2-point conversion away from winning. And then they won this game.
You are right about that. I gotta give you that one.
Appreciate that.
People tell me in the street, man, you gotta give Nick a little more credit.
Thank you.
Well, okay.
In the street.
Now he got that right. Now he'll be off for the next 2 years.
All right, on to the Panthers now. Yesterday, head coach Ron Rivera left the press conference abruptly, upset over the number of questions he was getting about Cam Newton's status for Sunday. If Cam is unable to go with the injured foot, Kyle Allen will start in his place. Nick, should Cam sit out Sunday's game?
Listen, if he looks like he looked the last time we saw him play on Thursday night, if he's still not healed after the extended, you know, mini bye week, then yes, he should sit out. Because I haven't seen Kyle Allen play since college. I know he bounced around colleges after being number one player in the country, coming out of high school, number one quarterback in the country, I should say. But sight unseen, anyone that's on an NFL roster, I think, could be more effective than that hampered Cam Newton we saw on Thursday night. So if Cam's not feeling better, and if that foot sprain's not healed, then yeah, he should sit out and try to get right.
If he has sprained his foot last Thursday, I would be like, I'd be a little more optimistic he can get out there. But this is over 4 weeks ago. You're talking about when this is New England preseason. He took some time off at the end of preseason and now getting it injured. To me, let's get him healthy. Let's rest him now. Let's lean on that defense, the running game. Keep the team in contention. Have Cam when he's back and healthy, because you can't change your throwing motion when you can't plant that lead foot.
All right, on to the Packers now. They host the Broncos Sunday, and while the Packers are undefeated, Aaron Rodgers has yet to have a big game. He has 3 touchdowns and 0 picks. Good, but not great by his MVP standards. See, how has Rodgers looked in Matt LaFleur's offense to you?
He's looked good enough for me, but I'm not going to be concerned about that. We know who Aaron Rodgers is, and we wanted this Packers team to be less reliant on Aaron Rodgers. This is the first time. I mean, they might have had one season in there when Aaron was there. They had a top 10 defense. This is the first time I've been in broadcasting. I can say Green Bay Packers with the defense. Since Reggie White left, and I was playing against Reggie and them twice a year, man, they have not had the type of defense I think they're going to end up with. They have been outstanding the first couple weeks. So I'm okay. I'm okay with Aaron with a slower start because they've got proven weapons in Devontae Adams, their receiver, and Aaron Rodgers. I'm not worried about them as much.
And I talked to, I think, their best defensive player, Kenny Clark, this week, and it seems like there's an enormous amount.
Kenny Clark, he's a fan of the show.
He is.
Hey, fans out there, get some Pro Bowl votes and everything.
Yeah, Kenny Clark.
Let's rig it up for him.
100% right. Young nose tackle for Green Bay, and there seems to be almost an infectious optimism about the level of talent on that Packers defense. For Rodgers and the offense, by the way, the Broncos might be a good team to get on track against. They have, on the year, the Broncos defense, zero sacks, two quarterback hits. Amazing how ineffective that Broncos pass rush has been when that's been their calling card. So we'll see if the Packers can get offense get on track.
Did Kenny Clark tell you I played with his dad in Philadelphia?
He did not tell me that. Are you sure that's accurate?
Another one of my little roll off of being part of Chris Carter.
No.
Me and you, homie.
I didn't know that. Next time I talk to him.
On to the Saints. Now, this we know. No Drew Brees this Sunday on the road to face the Seahawks. He's still out with the injured thumb. Who will replace him? Well, that we don't know. Sean Payton has yet to name a starter, whether that's Teddy Bridgewater or Taysom Hill. He does have Alvin Kamara and Michael Thomas on offense to help out whoever ends up behind center. Chris Carter, can the Saints stay in the playoff hunt without Drew Brees?
Oh, this is going to be a tough task. This is going to be tough. They have to make sure that they don't put too much stress on Teddy throwing the ball down the field, try to manage the game, because they should be able to keep this game fairly close with their defense. The Saints do have a good defense. They're going to be able to put a lot of pressure on Russell Wilson. This is not one of the more sophisticated offenses, Nick.
No.
Not one of Nick Wright's favorite game teams to watch, even though Russell's one of his favorite guys to watch. Yep. So keep the game close. The Saints have tremendous special teams. Let Teddy get a feel for the game, because starting the game is totally different. I do like the fact that Sean Payton, old school. I'm not giving people too much information. I'm not telling them what the game plan is. Let Pete Carroll and them sweat it out. Let their defense this week, if there's 100 defensive plays that they can have in practice, we want them to practice 50 for Taysom Hill and 50 for Teddy Bridgewater, compared to announcing the starter on Tuesday, allowing Pete and them to have their game plan to be, you know something, we're going to do 90% Teddy and only 10 on the backup quarterback. So that advantage of not knowing is an advantage that Sean Payton, he is utilizing that, and they will have some surprises. I wouldn't be surprised if Taysom Hill played quarterback at least 15 plays in the game.
Wow.
Typically, you have 65 plays. I believe 15 plays minimum, Sean Payton gets him involved. Not because he doesn't believe in Teddy, because he is a legitimate offensive threat running it and throwing it, Nick.
And whether he lines up under center for 15 plays is one thing. I would imagine he'll be on the – there'll be a lot of plays where Teddy and Taysom Hill are on the field at the same time.
Yes.
If you remember last year, there was a play where Drew Brees, Teddy, and Taysom, all three of them were on the field at the same time. Didn't know what the hell was going on. Here's what the Saints have going for them, even though I think they're going to lose this weekend. Going to Seattle is hard for anyone, much less for Teddy Bridgewater, who's making his first true start. He started week 17 last year, but his first true start in since the knee injury, essentially, as far as the game that really matters in 4 years, is that all of a sudden the NFC South, who, like, if you are 3-3, are you still alive for the division? Probably. Carolina's 0-2 and quarterback injury. Atlanta, we've seen them hot and cold this year. They're fortunate. They needed a 4th-and-3. Brilliant play by Julio Jones. Mm-hmm. And Tampa, I know they just won. They still have Jameis as their quarterback. They're still going to have issues. So the division that I thought could potentially produce at least two, if not three, playoff teams, all of a sudden, just two games into the year, looks a little different. So they don't have to play great. But The most important thing for this game against the Seahawks to me, see, is Teddy Bridgewater getting some confidence. Teddy has not played a great stretch of football, even a couple series in a row, since that knee injury. He now is going to be relied on. I know they haven't announced him as starter. He's going to be the starter. Going to be relied on as the starting quarterback for at least a month in New Orleans. Even if you don't come away with a win, if Teddy can start to get his legs under him to a degree, then all of a sudden you're like, okay, we've got a tough stretch after this with Dallas, but then we have Tampa Bay. We have a game against Arizona a few weeks after that. Can you do enough with Teddy in this game so you feel better about Teddy over the next month? That, to me, is the key in this game for New Orleans, because going to Seattle's tough putt for anybody.
All right, let's move on and talk Eagles. The team opted for a walkthrough Wednesday.